medieval period, you have learned about kings and queens and about their weapons. In modern period, you have learned about new technology, means new technology world. Post-independence period. Now, what is post-independence period? Post-independence period means the period 1947 or 1950 onwards. Now, all this period, ancient period, medieval period and modern period, how you learned about this? As we were not present in that period, but we have learned this with help of material source, written source, oral source and audiovisual sources. Now these sources are also again bifurcated in different forms. But before learning that sources, if we are learning each sources, so we have to learn regional wise, national wise and international wise. Material sources are bifurcated into newspapers, periodicals, diaries, reference books, correspondence and archives, government gadgets, postage stamps and encyclopedias. Now, written sources. In written sources, you have newspaper. Newspaper is an important document which is found in a history, as it talks about the olden period when we were not present in that period. The first newspaper was introduced by Hickey's Bengal Gazette, 1780 to 1782. Now, newspaper is considered to be fourth pillar of democracy. Afterwards, you have Press Trust India in 1953, means PTI. This is an agency or this is an organization where you gather all the news together. It is a non-profitable organization. After that, it is postage and stamps, which talks about the ancient period. Now, postage and stamp, you find postage and stamps in different colors with flowers, name of the persons.
Next, we will talk about postage and stamps. Postage and stamps don't reveal anything about their own, but still historians make them speak. Now, who are historians? Historians are the person who do research on certain topic of history, means of a past event. Postage stamps origin 1st July 1852. It was originated on 1st July 1852. It was introduced by St. George on 1st October 1854. First time it came to India on 21st November 1947. It reveals a lot about changing size, color, shapes and so on. It has variety of themes, covered political leaders, flowers, animals, birds, etc. It covers the events of golden, silver, diamond, century, bicentury and tricentury. Now we'll talk about Jell Cooper. 1977. He was the first Philatelic Bureau founder. Jell Manikji Cooper, F.R.G., was an Indian philatelist and an expert and authenticator of the postage stamps and political history of India speaks about Jell Cooper. He was born in Paris, household in Mumbai. He was a founder of first empire of Indian Philological Society. Jell Cooper edited India's stamp journals. He was an introducer for the Society of the Stamps.
Next we will talk about
material sources. Material sources are those sources which can be seen. It is scientifically proved and verified by the historians. Now, who are the historians? Historians are those persons who do research on history topic for a particular subject. Now, what are material sources? Coins, place of worship, things, royal seals, ornaments, museums, clothing and modern architecture. This all sources talks from the ancient period to medieval and from medieval to modern. Now let's see about coins. Coins, now you all have seen coins are of different types. Now we have the coins which is in steel metal. Same way the coins tells the story of history with the proof of past, present. It covers the changing phases in the printing of currency notes. The headquarter of it is in Mumbai and we have Printing Notes Reserve Bank of India. We will talk about audiovisual source. Now what is audiovisual sources? Audiovisual sources are those sources where we can hear and we can see also. Audiovisual sources are the electronic device. It is an electronic medium. It exhibits greater impact on the viewer, which gives long lasting image of certain things which they have seen. FTII. FTII means Film and Television Institute of India. Now in this Film and Television Institute of India covers all the public education. It provides public education to the society. An institute called Indian News Review gives all the informations about news of current event, past event and whatever is beneficial for the society. Till now we have learned sources of history for writing the history of modern India of our 21st century, which is changing on so rapidly, giving chances for new sources from landline to telephone, telephone to cell phone and cell phone to pager. Pager did not last for longer period, which did not survive, it died earlier. Now we are exploring in the internet world, which has captured whole universe, where we have taken a pause in 2020 to welcome a new invention of COVID-19, which attracted whole universe and made them to take a pause. As it is truth have authenticity and verified by scientifically proved. It has created a history which has touched all the aspects of our lives. Efforts made at all levels. As we are the real repellent, means we are the real proof of this pandemic COVID-19, which created a history of 2020. So we should also contribute to the efforts of our great warriors who are fighting against COVID-19 by staying safe at home. Thank you. Let's take a review of this lesson, that what we have learned in this lesson. We have learned in this lesson different sources of history of ancient, medieval and modern. The sources of history are material source, oral source and written source. Now you will complete the exercise given on the page number 4. Thank you. Have a nice day.